In this video, we are going to look at the differential diagnosis of a C6, C7 radiculopathy and median nerve entrapment in carpal tunnel syndrome.
Enroll in our online course now. Link is in the video description.
Hi and welcome back to Physiotutors. When assessing a patient with neurological symptoms in the upper limb, such as decreased sensation or diminished strength, one of your hypotheses is usually cervical radiculopathy. On our channel, you will find several videos that discuss the assessment of cervical radicular syndrome, such as the cluster of Wehner or peripheral neurological assessment. However, in some instances, peripheral nerve entrapments should not be disregarded as a differential diagnosis, as they can mimic symptoms of an affected cervical nerve root when a patient presents with peripheral neurological symptoms. So let's take a look at the carpal tunnel in detail. As you can see, the carpal tunnel tightly packs 9 tendons next to the median nerve between bony and ligamentous borders. Looking at this cross-section right here of the carpal tunnel, you can imagine that any pathological change in the carpal tunnel may lead to nerve irritation. Patients with a radicular syndrome of nerve roots C6, C7 may display sensory loss or disturbance in the lateral forearm, thumb, index finger, and middle finger. The sensory loss of patients with median nerve entrapment is similar in the hand of the affected arm, commonly described to be palmar only. Recent research, however, shows that 2/3 of patients with carpal tunnel syndrome display with symptoms that do not match this distribution and are rather glove-like, which blurs the line between the two pathological pictures as far as sensory loss is concerned. The differentiating factor between carpal tunnel syndrome and radiculopathy of C6, C7 is the diminished motor function. While C6, C7 radiculopathy may affect biceps, brachioradialis, plus wrist extensors, and triceps, wrist flexors, and finger extensors respectively, carpal tunnel syndrome only affects the thenar and first two lumbrical muscles, which are innervated by C8 and T1. So testing thumb abduction can give you the clue that the carpal tunnel syndrome may mimic symptoms of cervical radiculopathy. Alright, thanks a lot for watching. If you want to learn more about carpal tunnel assessment, you can go ahead and watch the playlist on the left. If you like this video, please give it a like and comment below to support our channel. If you are new here, we appreciate if you subscribe to us and hit the bell icon to get notified once we upload new videos. Lastly, check the links in the video description down below for more useful resources. And as always, this was Andreas for Physiotutors. I'll see you in another video. Bye.